If I had to go back to one single event that cemented my connection to SAS, it would be 10 years ago at the height of the financial crisis when bad news every day, every single tech giant out there was laying people off. I remember everybody was nervous. You know, was today going to be the day? And it was back in January. And at the beginning of the year, and Dr. Goodnight got on the webcast that day, and he said very clearly and plainly, listen, I'm not going to lay anybody off. That is my commitment to you. But what I ask of you is that you work hard, keep expenses low, and we will get through this together. Right? And being in sales for lots of tech companies, I'd never seen that kind of loyalty, that kind of care. And that changed certainly how I looked at my employment here. And I do remember, and just the collective sigh of relief, right? I have 5 kids at home. You know, my employment's a pretty critical factor to my life, to everybody's life. And just for him to have the thoughtfulness to do that, certainly just, I don't know, inspired me on a whole new level than any other employer I've ever had. And so what that did was that inspired in me just this desire to do good for the company, to represent SAS well, to the United Nations. At that time, I was a sales rep for the United Nations. And that was interesting, just to watch how the care that we had as a company for our employees translated to our customers, an organization like the United Nations that is out to do some wonderful things in the world, but has very little funds to do it. And what I saw was just time after time, when the UN came to us with these ideas of, hey, we want to test out analytics, or we want to be able to use big data and so forth, and when they didn't have necessarily the funding for it, SAS would step up and say, you know what, it's okay, let's just do this together because it's the right thing to do. And so we were able to tell some amazing stories through some of those projects on how we help modernize disaster response, or how we help them, you know, predict unemployment using social media, text analytics, and so forth. But when you work for a company that cares so much, it creates this culture that keeps us from turning our backs on problems that we know analytics can solve. I'm so grateful to work for a company that doesn't want to just tell stories, but also wants to make it so that anyone can be a part of the story and help create some new stories. Sometimes I think we just come in and keep our heads down and we're so focused on our work that we don't realize that, you know, that line of code that you just wrote or that technical document that you just published, you know, all of that, yes, while it contributes to SAS's commercial success, it also helps us do so much good in the world.